This is the this line can fall. There is a kyphosis, more kyphosis here. This line can fall here. This vertical line can fall here. So the 8 cm referring from the anterior aspect of the S1 to this line. This patient is a good candidate for SPL because this is line is falling on the S1 itself. But some patient will be stooping forward like that because of the lumbar lordosis. Here, good thing about this patient, the lumbar lordosis is there. If the lumbar lordosis is not there and we have the thoracic kyphosis, this line will fall somewhere here. So this distance we are measuring.
And this is starting from C7.
Yeah. No, the anterior and inferior part of the C7. Anterior inferior part of C7. Now, after correction also, this correction, line is ideally should be falling the posterior superior part of the S1. Now that they restored that. This is actually more anterior, but basically this is balanced. So we'll discuss SPO and during the dissection, I think. Coming on to the PSO, it is called a pericle subtraction osteotomy, described by any doubts about the PCO? We'll complete that and we'll go there.
Yeah, any doubts? First and foremost thing was like it should be flexible, disc, and it should not be fused to be eligible, and then rest of the things. Any other doubts? I think we can move
on. Yeah, SPO was done actually for the ankylosing spondylitis by the Smith-Patterson did the surgery for ankylosing spondylitis, that is still spine. But he achieved the correction by giving too much force and rupturing the anterior part or breaking the anterior cortex. The problem is if you that will create an anterior lengthening. If the iota calcified, this lengthening they won't the iota cannot tolerate if it's a calcified like that. There can be a rupture of the vessels also can happen along with that. That is why we are later this change to a flexible spine with a flexible disc with no anterior instrumentation and all, we can do the SPO technique. Now we can see Pondy has described this on the flexible spine. That is the major difference between SPO Smith-Patterson and Pondy's osteotomy. Now basically we call it as SPO. SPO is basically means a Pondy's technique they are preferring. How many degrees of correction you need? Each level can give you from 5 degree to 15 degree, average 10 degree correction you will get. Say for example, there is a kyphosis, round smooth kyphosis by 25 degree or something. You can do 2 level or 3 level, maybe 4 level to get a more harmonious correction. 2 level above and 2 level below that. And you need to put screws on the this level also where you are doing the osteotomy. It is greater accordingly. Now the pedicle subtraction osteotomy will give you more correction. Where here it is also in 1985. It was also called transpedicular wedge procedure, closing wedge osteotomy, axial osteotomy. This itself is telling you the technique also, what is mean by pericle subtraction osteotomy. Basically, it involves you have to take this much of bone and in a triangular shaped bone, and the apex of this triangle should be the anterior cortex of the selected vertebra. All these posterior elements like inferior part of the lamina, spinous process,
then inferior facet, superior facet, and superior part of inferior lamina, transverse facet, you are removing. Then you're creating a gap, that much of gap like that. Then you take all this and then you will expose pedicles on the both sides. Pedicle is removed and through this pedicle, we all know that inside there is a cortical rim around the pedicle. Inside is the cancellous bone. Then you start taking the cancellous bone till you get a remove this much wedge of the bone, and then once that is done, you close this gap. There will be a break fracture of the anterior cortex, but it will come together and you get a low doses instead of kyphosis, you can get corrected. You can use drill, you can use curettes because it's a cancellous bone. Then you can use curettes to take out all the cancellous bone, and then you can break the lateral cortex with a osteotome or a drill, whatever you can you are comfortable. So this will give you about 35 degrees of low doses. And in lumbar spine, and approximately 25 degrees of kyphosis correction in the dorsal spine. This is the technique I told you. Indications are coronal sinus imbalance, ankylosing spondylitis, post-traumatic kyphosis. But there is some relative contraindication like anterior pseudarthrosis, posterior wound infection, and or active bacterial infection elsewhere, like a medical nutritional anterior instrumentation, as in SPO. The best candidate for PSO is sharp or focal kyphosis, sagittal imbalance, we are discussing more than 10 centimeter. And a fixed disc space. So this if there, it is better to go for a PSO rather than a PCO, posterior column osteotomy. Pedicle subsequent osteotomy better than a posterior column osteotomy. The same thing, sorry for that. And the difference is there you have to do a multiple level osteotomy to get the correction. Here, only single segment osteotomy is good enough. So your instrumentation is also will be shorter. Patient position you have to expose two level up in normal patient, but in osteoporosis may have to go three level to get the desired correction. Probably we can discuss this all this during that time. That is why I'm just running it. Anyway, I just show the like that. You have to take the pedicle. You have to take the cancellous bone through the pedicle. Then the lateral wall is also removed. Then you have created a wedge. See that that is the wedge left there. Then you close the wedge. Then this will come together and contact will come with each other. This is the clinical picture. You can see that this is a pedicle through which we created a defect like that. So this defect is like this. It is an angular defect. Then with the instrumentation, you just close it. So these two will come together, and because the bone inside will close like that, so you will get a low dose. That is a simple principle. After taking all the cancellous bone, you need a specialized instrumentation are there. Otherwise, something take a curette or something slowly you have to get it done. That you should do lastly, because once that is done, there can be epidural bleeding and other things. You won't able to do the other things. So keep that plate till the last step. It will not move. There can be, without forcing it, this can be buckled. Ideally, it's fine, no problems. But if it is buckling,
posteriorly, you can compress the diaphragm.
Yeah, that's what the osteotomy is like. You have to do, and there is specific manual. It's like we can demonstrate here like how to do it, but doing it is a big job. And it requires meticulous planning. That's why, like as he was pointing out, not to damage neurological structure. So when you will be in workshop or when you will be seeing from here, what you have to see basically. See, these are not deformed cadavers. These are normal cadavers. So you will be not doing that maneuvers that can straighten things up. But you have to keep an idea about things like how to remove that bone, what are the neurological like nerves exiting and traversing nerve root will be there, and how to not to damage dura. How to work and understand this neurological anatomy is the focus of the workshop basically.
So the basic difference between these two, PSO address of focal angular kyphosis more effectively than a PCO or SPO. PSO does not lengthen the anterior column as does in SPO, which thus minimize stretching of the major vessels and viscera and it to the space. Okay. And 30 to 40 degree correction you will get. This correction you will get in a three column correction from the posterior approach. PSO does not lengthen the anterior column. We have discussed that. At the osteotomy, accomplish bone to bone contact in posterior, middle, and anterior column. So there is a maximized healing potential and bone fusion. Even it is doesn't matter whether anteriorly there is ankylosis or that the anterior longitudinal ligament is calcified, because this is done inside the vertebral body. We are not depend on the disc space or anterior superior inferior or anything. We are actually shortening the body such a way that it's an angular shortening, such a way that the posterior shortening will be more and anterior shortening is less. So that is why it is goes like this vertical. If you shorten like this, and you don't, your aim is to get a low doses like that. So you take more bone from posterior and less bone on anterior. You close it, then you will get the shape like this. So that you can maintain a low doses like that, 30 to 40, 45 degree, 40 degree low doses. You can get it with a single level. If you want to get that much of low doses in posterior column osteotomy alone, you have to do a lot of work, lot of levels you have to do. Still, you may not be able to get that much. It can be done in two level, if depending on the two level or up to three level, you can do it actually. But basically, this if there is a possibility of doing in the lumbar spine, that will be better. If the angular kyphosis or dorsal region, you cannot do it on the lumbar level. But in a round kyphosis, you can go to L1 or L2. That region is better because the spinal cord is not there. You can safely close the this defect like that. But you can do it in the in the dorsal spine. A dorsal spine, the correction you will get is less than and the lumbar spine. That's all about this. We will discuss that. That is why taken a detailed this thing.
Yeah, now you got a fair idea about
dissection.
They have got a fair idea about what is to be done,
yeah,
so that they can consult.
Just to get some, what is basically this presentation, what is PCO, what is posterior column osteotomy, what is pedicular subtraction osteotomy. That's it. Rest of the things we can discuss during the demonstration time. Then vertebral column resection is that the other one, that is the most the mild, moderate, and this is severe form of osteotomy.
VCR one, right?
VCR.
Yeah. So these are the graded one. Like this is not very frequently we do it, right?
Yeah, very VCR for me, I do it for the cases where for the tumors actually, not for the deformity. Deformity we general because most of the deformity may be corrected by a pedicular subtraction osteotomy, but VCR the complete resection of the posterior posterior elements as well as the vertebral body, that is VCR. Vertebral column resection. This generally we do it for the tumors where we can do it in an end block kind of thing, where we take the posterior elements in a single block and anterior column in a single block. Very rarely we do
complete VCR in deformity. Nowadays we are not getting this kind of deformity. That is why we are not doing it. This can be done as a two-stage. We can be done. That is, VCR can be done as two techniques are there. One is you do a posterior osteotomy, anterior osteotomy followed by a posterior osteotomy. Or you can do it in a single sitting, PVC, a posterior vertebral column resection. I do a PVC because that will be more convenient for the patient as well as you don't have to go to the theater in 2 days for a single surgery. So what basically we do here is we have to take this much of bone. The idea is to take the VCR or whatever called osteotomy at this level, you have to get this much of bone out. Like you have to remove the part of the rib there, you have to remove posterior inferior part of the lamina, superior part of the inferior lamina. This entire lamina pedicle you have to remove from there. Then once that is done, you have to put screws on the upper and lower spine. Then you have to start drilling from one pedicle to other pedicle. But if you are looking for a end block dissection, you better not to drill it. There are other techniques for that. Maybe we can discuss later. But this for the deformity, you can drill it, and from one side to this side, this again you have to drill. Entire vertebral body should be drilled like that. In a deformity, you want the vertebral body will be one side. It is not a symmetric thing in a deformity. So you take the pedicle that on that side, then drilling, you have to do it from the convex side where you can see the vertebral body more clearly from the convex side. Start drilling there. Take out all the bone from the. I take out the bone as well as the disc superiorly and inferiorly. Then you put a small cage here that will serve as a pivot. Over which you are going to compress this. This is one of the few cases you can do that this severe deformity, very, very severe, all the, this area all fused. Because it's all fused, you will not get any reduction by forcing the rod to the screws and all this scoliosis routine maneuvers will not help here. So here we have to do, take a one vertebral body and the vertebral body, and then you create some space there, then you correct the deformity. That is the idea. We are shortening the vertebral column to get the deformity corrected. The normal scoliosis surgery, actually we just stretch this to get the spine straight. Here we shorten this this part, and once it is shortened, you can get a correction here. You got the point here, no? Here we are the apical vertebra will remove, one or two vertebra depending on the deformity size. You remove this vertebra, and then you can correct this deformity. Because this will be more flexible. The flexibility is, we are creating a flexibility here by shortening the vertebral column or taking in one or two segments of the vertebral column, and we are getting corrected. But this area is again very stiff. This is also stiff. We are not, that is why this is not get corrected that much. We got this correction because there is nothing there in the center, so we could reduce this scoli part. That is why this is not completely reduced here, because this part is stiffness is still there, this part of stiffness is still there. But basically you will get a good kyphosis also, because if you make the one, you make a stick like that, you break it, then you can adjust anywhere, any way you can adjust. This is a single, if the, this is not a flexible thing. If flexible, you can just flex it and correct it. But if it's not flexible, what you have to do, you take break this, make some space here,
then you can do your correction maneuvers. No, they put K because space is too less to get. Yeah, this basically we did it for the scoliosis correction. The cage is we are placing it for the kyphosis correction. This is mainly for the scoliosis. If you put a cage there, that much you losing that much space to get the spinal column to move medially. But kyphosis, we need a fulcrum to get it corrected. That is where the cage is placed. I think these are one of the. This doesn't matter anyway for those who are want to know about detail. We'll discuss that. I think that will be better. I have not prepared it in detail because it's supposed to be a. They're taken from the points of surgical resection in a PVCR. They probably can read it. It's a very busy slide. We can just let it be there, so those who want to read it can.
Yeah, we'll
any questions?
We'll share it. Anybody has any question as of now? I think most of them have been correct, and we can still discuss them from the.
Yeah, we can still discuss.
Yeah.
But still some doubt, some burning questions, anything?
Good.
This is from which paper?
This is. This one.
Yeah, we'll share this article with you on the group today.
Now they are using both cruciform muscular.
Yes.
Dramatic reduction in blood loss.
Yeah.
They just cut a wedge and take out the blood.
Yeah.
So if there is no question, we can quickly break for snacks and tea. And again, like for those who are coming first time in this lab, demonstration will be from the lab here. It will be shown on this screen. It will be quite good, and you can discuss whatever things you want from here. Nobody have to come there in the lab, and those who has registered for hands-on will be allowed to go in the lab in the afternoon, after the lunch. So again, like if at all we have something extra, we'll bring it out here. Again, we'll meet you after lunch, and we can solve if any other queries you have. Yeah.
N-block of scoliosis not necessary. Where do you want to do N-block?
I mean, would it be easier to do N-block compared?
N-block has got its own problems. N-block, we see N-block. The problem is we have to cut the pedicle. In scoliosis, we generally.